This HackerRank challenge is called Making Anagrams. In the first paragraph, they write, we consider two strings to be anagrams of each other if the first string's letters can be rearranged to form the second string. In other words, both strings must contain the same exact letters in the same exact frequency. They give an example, BACDC is an anagram of DCBAC. So what we have to do here is find the minimum number of characters that can be deleted to make two strings anagrams of each other. This is how we're going to create our solution. First, we're going to create an int array. We're going to call that alphabet, and it's going to contain 26 elements. These 26 elements are going to be integers corresponding to every character in the alphabet. Index 0 here is going to be for A, index 1 is going to be for B, index 2 is going to be for C, and so on, all the way to index 25 corresponding to the character Z. Assuming we have two strings, S1 and S2, here we have CDE for the value of S1 and ABC for the value of S2. What we have to do to make these strings anagrams is delete D and E in the first string and A and B in the second string so that we are only left with C. And C here is the only character that appears in both strings with the same frequency because it appears once in S1 and once in S2. So we need to make four deletions, D and E and A and B. The approach we'll use is to go through the first string character by character and then increase the counts or the occurrence of that character in the array. So we're going to find the index for C, which is ABC, it's index 2 here, and we're going to decrease it first for S1. So 0 minus 1 is going to be negative 1. Then we meet D here, we find the index corresponding to D, and we decrease it by 1. So this here becomes negative 1. We do the same thing for E right here, and we decrease it by 1. Then we go ahead and we loop through S2, which is our second string, and we repeat the same process, but this time, instead of decrementing the values, we rather increment them. So we go to A, we increase that by 1, then we go to B, we increase that by 1, and then we go to C, and negative 1 plus 1 equals 0. So notice here that 0 here, the index corresponding to the character C, has been balanced out. The last step now to find the number of deletions is to loop through this entire array and count the sum of absolute values. So here negative 1, we don't really care if it's negative or positive. What we want to find is the absolute value. So we need to sum up 1 plus 1, that is 2, plus 1 here because it's the absolute value. So we have 3 plus 1 here, and then we have 4. So the number of deletions here is 4. And this matches our findings from the earlier step. In code, this is how it is. We have our int alphabet here, which is an array of 26 characters. We initialize all the values to 0, and then we have this sum variable here with the value 0. Then we loop through our first string, which is S1, all the way to the end, and we get the corresponding index for the character at this current iteration. If you look through my strings playlist here, you will see that I use this technique a lot. We do the same thing here for S2, but for S2, notice that here we have the increment operator, whereas for S1, we have the decrement operator here. Once we are done with the processing of both strings, we simply loop through our alphabet array and we sum up the absolute values from the first index to the last index. And this gives us the sum or the character deletions that we need to make. So let's run this code here. We've passed the two sample test cases. So now I'm going to submit this code. We have 16 test cases and we've passed all of them. So that's it. This was called Making Anagrams. If you like my solution, please subscribe to my channel. Check out my GitHub in the description of this video, and I'll catch you next time.